Hello everyone, welcome to part 10 of my Civilization 5 game here. This time around it's going to be more of the same, starting in turn 839. I still need to get my military built up, and I also need to, or at least I want to, do a secondary expansion phase here and fill in this area here. And I want to do that mostly so one of the AI civs doesn't come along and plop a city down there and then use it for staging an attack or something like that. I'm also currently waiting for my first factories to finish so that I can select a ideology. Okay, we got something actually going on this turn, so we'll have to look into that. Let's see. Well, there isn't much doing here. That tile can be improved. Aha! So we'll attack here. There we go. That clears up that barbarian ship. Let's see. Oh, right. I gotta redo that. Oh, I can upgrade my ships. Yeah, I think it's a good idea to do that. No, I can only do one at a time here, due to the cost, but... Okay, he's offering iron. No. I don't actually need iron. I'm far more interested in gold. And one gold really isn't enough. Two gold? No. Oh, two turns for archaeology. Right, okay, I can park my frigate. Oh yes, the Huacho is doing so. Oh, I can upgrade that to a cannon. Right. That's definitely good to do. Okay, right, this I was going to make a farm on. This is in range of Suwon here. There really isn't much else except around up here to do the improvements on at this point in time. Anyway, whoops. Okay, there's archaeology. Now what should I go for? Scientific theory gives me public schools. Rifling gives me riflemen. Military service, cavalry, Brandenburg Gate, or fertilizer. Fertilizer is the one. That's going to improve my growth significantly. Now, what can I build? Oh, Circus Maximus. Now I can build East India Company. Well, that's not all that important at this point. Oh, I need barracks for heroic epic. I need some temples and opera houses. What I'm going to do is catch up on the other buildings here in Seoul. So I'll start with the science ones. Oh, right, I need to park the cannon. And we'll get moving here. This really gets tedious after a while. Right. So we're still waiting for things to happen here. Good, we finished mining our coal here. Now we'll get on with improving tiles around the city there. What have we built? A garden. You know what? We've got enough coal, we can build factories everywhere. The coal being within our borders, we don't have to worry about it going away in trade. Okay, this is a hill by a river. We've got lots of production building here. So I'll make a farm out of it, which ironically increases the production. Right, okay, what was doing here? Right. I think I may have mentioned this previously, but I basically play algorithmically. So I have certain patterns that I work on that I found work. And I basically just follow them. It means I don't generally have to remember what I'm doing from turn to turn. That, of course, doesn't hold all of the time. Sometimes, of course, you have a particular task you need to finish. But in general, for improvements and so on, I just have a basic set of things that I do for every tile of a particular type. Right. So it looks like I'm not likely to have too much trouble with happiness in the empire now. What with having 24 happiness surplus right now. Okay, this is a hill, so we mine it. Again, I don't generally worry about the 2 science points you get from jungle tiles, because I usually have enough science going on by this point that I don't really need it. If you are playing on a higher difficulty level, then it might be important to keep it. Since I'm playing on so-called normal difficulty, it's not so critical. Certainly on Deity, you'd want every single bit of science you can get. And I'm not interested in somebody else's wars. Given that I started out basically on an isolated chunk of the continent, I don't have any shared borders with anybody that are contested. And that's actually been improving my relations with other civilizations as a result. And I actually build barracks here. Okay. You want to keep an eye on these just in case they're plotting against you or a sneak attack against you. Because if they are, you really need to prepare for it. No, again, with somebody else's war. You'd really have to make it worth my while to join in. So real soon now, I should get that third factory. Okay, so that has basically covered everything there. So now I'm up to this guy here. So I'll start filling those tiles. Seoul, I built. Okay, that's a university. What to build now? Well, let's get the sea improvements going. That certainly can't harm the overall functioning of the city. Ah, there we go. That gives us a significant increase in food production because non-freshwater farms have now have extra food. Okay, redid that. Okay, one, two. This one also needs to be irrigated, farmed, I guess. Now what? Scientific theory is a good one. And I've built a zoo here. Let's put the factory. And we have the factory here. I'll go for the barracks. Now we have the ideology. Now you could go with autocracy is actually pretty good. And a lot of the other civilizations will tend to pick it. It has some really good tourism tenets in there. Order has some nice stuff as well. Like they're all good. I'm gonna go with freedom though. And that means that I can go ahead and select my early adopter tenants. Now, we have some potential useful tenants here. Avant-garde is good for great people generation. We can have extra culture from great works. That's not so good unless you have stacks of them. This is good if you have lots of specialists. This one's not so good unless you're worried about unless you're sending your spies into city states. This is really good for happiness. This is not as good, but it's not bad either. And this adds happiness for national wonders. Now we can only choose level 1 tenets at this point because you need two of them to get a level 2. So I'm going to start out with the great people one. And yeah, I could go with the happiness, which would be nice. Or do I want my specialists to consume less food? And you know what? I'm going with the specialist one. Okay, so that's that. And that's actually made a difference here. Oh, look at that. Most of our buildings are full of specialists. Right. Okay. Freedom also unlocks a wonder. I can't remember which one. I don't know if I have the tech yet for it either. Okay, so we'll keep things rolling along here. It's 45 turns before we're voting on the World's Fair. The question is, what is the other proposal? World Congress. Ban porcelain. Okay. Porcelain being a luxury you can only get from city-states. Okay, so that's that. Nothing more I can do there. Okay, so it's one, two, three. So that one is definitely one to fill in. And it sounds like I have a friend come to visit. Otherwise known as a cat. Cat came and said hello. And oh, there's the cat. Okay. Aha! Got barbarians over here. Well, I think we should deal with the barbarians. Send my, crossbowmen out there. The advantage of the crossbowmen over. Yeah, we still can't reach. Okay. Oh, Brussels is 6 gold now. Okay. The crossbowman is nicer than the cannon and so on for that sort of thing because it doesn't need to set up before firing. Now, the setup just basically uses up a movement point, which means you can't move and fire at the same on the same turn. That's a hill with a river. I'm gonna mine that, I think. Yes. That's gonna be a farm. And let's see. So I'm gonna have to go looking for that encampment that has to be around here somewhere. Then when I accumulate enough gold, I think I'll buy a settler. I think they'll settle right here on the hill. Got bananas right there. And I cover the land area pretty good. Okay, so I'll put the crossbowmen back in the city. Now I'll, yeah, I'll just park him. Okay, so let's see. Ah, there's the encampment. Okay, what have I. Okay, that was. I'm gonna build the museums because they're culture and it gives me art and artifact slots, which are useful to have. So I figure it's the location of Sofia and Ragusa here that pretty much prevented me from having any complications with. I'm gonna upgrade that guy to an explorer. Complications of other civilizations early on, and that actually helped my early game, because I didn't have to worry about defending myself. And that is a real concern, defending yourself from invasion if you happen to have close neighbors. Now, I don't worry about the civilization stealing techs. In Civ 5, you can't trade technologies. So it's the only way you can get a tech from another civilization is to steal them. And that, I think, is a major oversight. That you can't trade techs. Right, okay. I'm gonna park that guy. You know what? I'll take the crossbowman out here to attack that encampment. Oxford University. One free tech, that's worth rushing. Hurry production, okay. Okay, my free tech. Oh, I'm gonna get that one right away. Military science. Yeah, rifling. Okay, and production over here. Right, seaport. And here, I built a cannon. Factory there. Cannon. I'll just park it. And we'll head over here. Upgrade that to an explorer. Explorer being a stronger unit. With more movement points. The Explorer upgrade is from one of the mods I'm using. It doesn't make all that much difference to the gameplay, so it doesn't really unbalance anything. Okay, so I'll just wander this guy out here. Considerably stronger than the plain old scout. Right. Biology reveals oil. Steam power. Right. Electricity reveals aluminum. And, well, let's see. I think I'll go for military science here. Right. All right, that one can't shoot over obstacles. Right, okay, so I got a mine there. You can't improve an oasis. So, over here. And on we go. He wants truffles for iron and horses. No. There's no point trading for something you really don't need. Okay, so that is grassland forest. So that's going to get a mine on it. Okay, that clears that. I think that gets me a promotion. I'll send this one home. That's a Mayan scout. Well, he got a promotion. That was an insta-heal. Yeah, I did get a promotion. Increased visibility. Oh, look, there's something over here. Maybe I will go exploring. Oh, look, a bunch of tiny islands. With the mods that I'm using, these tiny islands are actually, once you get to the point you can build seaports, are not as bad as they would be in the stock game. I'm just going to go island hopping here and see what I can see. With the visible range of like 4, it's quite a range to see things. Okay, what have we got here? 3, 1... Well, that one's clearly a farm. We'll head over this way. Wow, and there's something up here. Oh, that's probably the other end of the continent. Ah, this guy's offering gold. Yes, we'll take that one. Right, okay. We need to embark there. Right. seven turns, Soul should be a really solid production base. With a real solid growth base behind it. So you can see I'm making good progress on the science now. Far cry from earlier when I had a gold deficit of 50 or what 35 or whatever it was. That was pretty crazy. But that just goes to show you that just because you're having a bad time early on, it doesn't mean that you're sunk. It doesn't mean you can't come back and still win the game, or at least make a good showing of it. Sure, if you get far enough behind, you are toast. But just because you're behind, it doesn't mean you are toast. Oh, that's yet another island in the island hopping chain. Now, early game, I wouldn't have been able to do this island hop because of these ocean tiles. Right, okay, so here, that's in range of a city. Put the pasture on there. Okay, hop to the next island out there. It is interesting that you don't get a sightline bonus while you're embarked, yet you would think that an explorer with a telescope would be able to see further, even embarked. Anyway, what have we finished an opera house here. Now the public school would be science. Museum is culture. I'm gonna go for museum. And we might actually, before the this part runs out of time, might actually get to the next World Congress. Okay, so there's no obvious directions to go for further land, but we know there's more land out that way because we've already gone around the world once. Okay, where are we here? One, two. This one is in range of the city, so that's a good one to improve. Now, the astute among you will realize that what I'm doing with these workers is a lot of busy work for the most part, because I'm improving tiles that there's a good chance the city will never actually use. But since I have the workers, I might as well improve everything, and then that gives my city governors more choice in actually managing the city. This is a grassland hill with no fresh water, so that gets a mine. Okay. Another few turns will be able to get me a settler, and I can start a secondary expansion phase. That will delay some of those national wonders because I'll have additional cities, but I'm not overly worried about that. So we'll keep on trucking across into the unknown here. And let's take a look here. What have we finished our seaport. Now, what do we have here? I think the bank would be a great idea. Get some gold, additional gold going. Wow, we got a great musician. Well, let's make a great work. Now, it turns out there's actually a maximum number of great works of any particular kind you can make in the entire game. You don't tend to run into that when you're playing with a standard number of civilizations. I was playing a game with 22 civilizations a while back, and before the Industrial Age, pretty much all of the great works were done. There weren't any more available. So that meant that I had to use musicians for concert tours, and I had to use writers for treatises, which was fine. That sort of thing. That's pretty much everything over on that quadrant there. That's just about everything there. So I'm going to have to go around that side. I need to re-up this. And let's just wander across some more here. So the coast is over there. Keep on, yeah, see there, you can see. Well, let's see what I get if I just keep going due west. East. That's east. Duh. Okay, so that is a plains hill. That's a mine. Okay, military science comes around this turn. There we go. And we'll keep going. Who's that? Well, that's the Aztecs. Right, I gotta re-up this one too. At least it tells you what the previous trade route was. Production over here. I finished the seaport. I'm going to build a barracks. I'm going to get all my barracks out. Now, let's see. Dynamite gives me artillery. I'll go for biology. That gets me oil. Then I'll see how well off I am for oil, since that's an important late game resource. Aluminum's the other really important one. Uranium you can do without, but you really do want some of it. You can, however, do without it. Right, I got another one to re-up here. Ah, okay, so that's that one's finished. 1, 2, 1, 2. Okay, there's another spot. Okay, well, that makes it all the way around. Looks like most of the civilizations on this map didn't have contested borders, which probably explains why there haven't been a lot of wars. Brussels. Right, that's my buddy over here. You know what? I will actually do the influence thing. Right, okay, so that is plains forest, so that's going to be a farm. Have to re-up this. Yeah, I don't have a open borders with the Aztecs, so I can't just wander around there with impunity. Right, I actually wanted to check on Seoul and see how. Okay, it's filled up all of the specialists here. Citizen. Okay, I don't have anybody unemployed. I'm not actually picking up these ocean tiles, probably because the land tiles are actually better. But at some point, I will start picking up the water tiles. And, you know, because it's certainly going to keep growing. No. I don't want iron. I don't need it. I still don't need iron. You can get some diplomatic positive modifiers for trading with civilizations, but for the most part, I don't find them terribly useful. Okay. We can reach Seoul now. We got a boost on range here. So I'll do that. I knew that would come. I wasn't sure it would come that soon. Okay. So if I can get on land, I'll get a pretty good sight line here. So that revealed a fair bit. Okay, I have built a museum there. Okay, public school will do. I got 2 turns for a bank in Seoul, and then I can go ahead and maybe build the Brandenburg Gate there. Just to get a larger space revealed. Well, that revealed. Oh, there's a city-state up there. I definitely want to meet the city-state. Metallurgy was stolen. Someone's way behind technologically. You definitely want to meet the city-states. You have to actually meet them physically, not just reveal their location on the map to actually talk to them. So it's definitely worth going on the expedition to do that. Okay, one, two, three. That is one that can be improved. Okay. I finished a factory there. Good. Barracks time. And I have finished the bank here. I'll go for the Brandenburg Gate there. I'm not gonna get huge amount of benefit from it, but if I manage to build it, nobody else does. And also, I get the culture benefit from it. Got a few turns left until the next social policy. Ah, the Aztecs finally made the industrial era. We met the city-state. I suspect how many city-states have been met? City-states. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, 11, 12, 13, 15. So there's a couple more out there. Okay, what have I? Well, that one is certainly productive enough to. Right. Architecture. Well, he's offering open borders, so yeah, we'll take that one. Okay, so we've arrived at the spot we're going to improve. That's a river hill. Yeah, we'll make a farm there. That's going to be a mine. And we'll wander about here a bit, see what we can find. Wow. So there's a barbarian up there. Okay, a couple more turns. Unless I spend gold on something else, I can buy me a settler. Ooh, a great scientist. Now I could plant the guy as a, an academy, but if we do this, and bam, there's a whole bunch of oil kicking about. Okay, let's wander about here a bit. See what we can find up here. Production. Okay, we've made ourselves a barracks. Public school seems like a good idea. And what should we science up? We'll go electricity. See if we have aluminum kicking about. Where are we getting the oil from? Oil there. Oil there. Oil there. Ah! Okay, that would do it. That's good. See, that's the great person improvement. It links up the strategic resource. And there you have it. That got us 14 oil from two locations without having to build the oil wells. Okay. There's another city-state up here. Sydney. Well, that's good to know. And I think there's another one. Okay, what? We finished a museum there. Public school. Okay, so that explorer with the promotions out the wazoo is actually quite effective at exploring. There we go, Kathmandu. Oh. Porcelain Tower. What's the Porcelain Tower do? I can never remember these things. Porcelain Tower. Requires rationalism. Great scientist appears. 50% more from research agreements. Okay. So it'd be good, but I don't really need it. What's the Uffizi do? Where is it? One free great artist appears, three slots for great works of art. Okay. Right, okay. Now I also have the option of going ahead and selecting an ideology tenet. But right, I'll go for aesthetics. Okay. I'll go after this pikeman here. Since, that's a city-state quest now. There's no oil nearby there to improve. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2. Okay, so that needs an improvement. Okay, so far so good there. Now, I was saying I wanted to get a settler out. So here we go. Just a few turns for the World Congress, and I think that after the World Congress is when I'm going to end up calling the part. That 6 turns, yeah, that'll take a little over to a little over an hour. Hey, there's my settler. And what do you know? It's making suggestions exactly where I would put my city. Now, we go 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. This gives us a perfect spacing here, but I don't have the river. If I put it here, I'm closer to the river. But if I put it here, I'm on the river. And that's what I'm going to do. One more turn, I should have that. And we've made a barracks here. I don't have good production here, so I'll just go for a factory there. When the World's Fair starts up, I'll switch all of my cities just about to producing that, just so that I can get first place for sure on that. It's well worth it, so it's worth delaying other things a little bit just to get that. Now, let's see. Reason I attacked with the cannon instead of the city is simply for the experience points for the cannon. All right, I need to improve that and clear the camp. Here we go. It's another one. A farm. Right, okay. And we'll moving along. Well, that's cute. 666 culture there. I'm basically just accumulating faith right now, for when it will be useful to buy great people later. Right, I need to. Okay. Friends with Sydney, so I can wander around in there. Okay. There's an outside chance that I'll still find some ancient ruins kicking about, actually. Especially in isolated places. Okay. Oh, there's more tiny islands out there. Okay, production here. I finished a factory. Go for a barracks. Okay, so a couple more turns and I'll call it after the World Congress vote. That is Forest Plains, so that gets a farm. If I wander over here. Yeah, I can see there really isn't much over that way. You'll see what's up there. Right, okay, I can plant my city here. Bang. There's my city. Right, I wanted to see what was kicking about up here. It doesn't seem to be a lot, but oh, there's the ice cap there. Right, I've got my. I'll start out with the shrine again. Okay, time to vote. I don't actually. I kind of want that one to pass. I'm not overly worried about the porcelain ban, but I'll vote against it. Okay, so we'll commit the delegates. Good. So we'll get the results of the vote here. Oh, apparently I have the most gold. The luxury ban passed. Huh. If I would have voted like two nay, it would have failed. Right, we can make a proposal here. We'll repeal the luxury ban for lack of anything better to do. Take a look. Ooh, there's a barbarian up there. Might as well clear that while I'm at it. And then we'll take a look at things over here. Yeah, I'll change the production here. World's Fair. World's Fair. I'll wait out the factory there. World's Fair. Yeah. Yeah, I'll wait the other ones out. Okay. Yeah, I'll wait that one out too. I'll run this turn out and I'll end it next time. Right. One, two, three. That one. Clear the camp there. That's pretty much it for that turn. And we'll see. Right. Okay. So I'm going to call it a part here. So I'll save the game. So that's getting some real progress going on the science there and working toward the culture. Where I'm aiming is broadcast towers and the like, which really improve the tourism. That gets you much closer to a cultural victory. And otherwise, I'm aiming for a science victory, so building the spaceship. Anyway, next time around, I should see the completion of the World's Fair and a whole bunch more exploration and a whole bunch more tedium. Anyway, if you've watched this far, thanks for watching. That's all for this time. I'll see you next time.